Chapter 11, Photosynthesis in Higher Plants, Question Answers from Class 11, Subject Biology. Exercises. Question 1. By looking at a plant externally, can you tell whether a plant is C3 or C4? Why and how? Answer. External morphology alone cannot definitely distinguish C3 and C4 species, because both groups include a wide variety of forms, herbs, shrubs, grasses. You can only make an educated guess by noting habitat and habit. C4 plants often thrive in hot, open, dry environments, example maize, sorghum, sugarcane. C3 plants are abundant in cooler, shaded habitats, example rice, wheat, most temperate trees. Ultimately, you need anatomical or physiological test, leaf cross-section, gas exchange measurements to confirm the photosynthetic pathway. Question 2. By looking at which internal structure of a plant, you can tell whether a plant is C3 or C4. Explain. Answer. You examine a transverse section of the leaf under the microscope. Friends, anatomy is diagnostic of C4 plants. It features large chloroplast-rich bundle-shaped cells forming a wreath, crowns around each vascular bundle. Distinct mesophyll layer surrounding the bundle sheath. C3 leaves lack crowns anatomy. Chloroplasts are distributed throughout mesophyll cells and there is no specialized bundle sheath chloroplast arrangement. Question 3. Even though a very few cells in a C4 plant carry out the biosynthetic Calvin pathway, yet they are highly productive. Can you discuss why? Answer. CO2 concentration mechanism. C4 mesophyll cells fix CO2 into 4 carbon acids which shuttle and release CO2 in bundle sheath cells. RuBisCO saturation. High local CO2 levels around RuBisCO minimize photorespiration and maximize carboxylation efficiency. Spatial separation of initial fixation, mesophyll and Calvin cycle, bundle sheath reduces wasteful O2 fixation, boosting net carbon gain per photon absorbed. Question 4. RuBisCO is an enzyme that acts as both as a carboxylase and oxygenase. Why do you think RuBisCO carries out more carboxylation in C4 plants? Answer. Elevated CO2. O2 ratio in bundle sheath cells drives the competitive binding towards CO2. Microenvironment control. C4 metabolism delivers CO2 directly to RuBisCO's active site, saturating it and suppressing O2 binding. Consequently, carboxylation far outpaces oxygenation, minimizing photorespiration. Question 5. Suppose there were plants that had a high concentration of chlorophyll B but lacked chlorophyll A. Would it carry out photosynthesis? Then why do plants have chlorophyll B and other accessory pigments? Answer. No. Chlorophyll A is the only pigment at the reaction center of both photosystems, P680, P700. Without it, the photochemical conversion of light to excited electrons cannot occur. Accessory pigments, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, xanthophylls exist because they extend the spectrum of light absorption beyond chlorophyll A peaks, transfer harvested energy efficiently to chlorophyll A, protect the photosynthetic apparatus from photooxidative damage. Question 6. Why is the color of a leaf kept in the dark frequently becomes yellow or pale green? Which pigment do you think is more stable? Answer. Chlorophylls degrade rapidly in darkness. No light-driven renewal, causing the green to fade. Carotenoids and xanthophylls are more stable, remaining in tissues longer and imparting a yellow-orange hue when chlorophyll is lost. Question 7. Look at leaves of the same plant on the shady side and compare it with the leaves on the sunny side. Or compare the potted plants kept in the sunlight with those in the shade. Which of them has leaves that are darker green? Why? Answer. Shade leaves are typically darker green because they develop higher chlorophyll concentration per unit area to capture limited light, thinner lamina allowing more efficient light penetration. Sun leaves, by contrast, are thicker with more protective features and often have a lower chlorophyll density per area. Question 8, figure 11.10, this one, shows the effect of light on the rate of photosynthesis. Based on the graph, answer the following questions. A. At which point, A, B or C, in the curve, light is a limiting factor? Answer. Point A, the initial rising portion is where light is the limiting factor. This one. This is the initial rising portion. B, what could be the limiting factor in region A? Answer. In region A, light intensity is subsaturating. All other factors, CO2, enzymes are in excess. C, what do C and D represent on the curve? C and D. C marks the light saturation point, maximum photosynthetic rate. D indicates the photoinhibition region where excessive light causes pigment damage and a decline in rate. Question 9. Give comparison between the following. A. C3 and C4 pathways. First CO2 acceptor, C3 pathway, ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate, RuBP. C4 pathway, phosphenol pyruvate, PEP, primary fixation product, C3 pathway, 3-phosphoglycerate, 3C, C4 pathway, oxaloacetate, malate, aspartate, 4C, leaf anatomy, C3 pathway, no crans, chloroplast in mesophyll, C4 pathway, crans, bundle shed, chloroplast, photorespiration, C3 pathway, significant at high O2, low CO2, C4 pathway, negligible. Key enzyme, C3 pathway, RuBisCO, carboxylase, oxygenase, C4 pathway, PEP, carboxylase, high CO2 specificity. B. Cyclic versus non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Photosystems involved, cyclic, photosystem 1 only, non-cyclic, photosystem 2 to photosystem 1. Products, cyclic, ATP only, non-cyclic, ATP plus NADPH plus O2. Electron flow, cyclic, recycles back to PSI, non-cyclic, linear from H2O to NADP positive. Occurrence, cyclic, under far red light or high ATP demand, non-cyclic, under full light, supplies both energy carriers. C. Leaf anatomy of C3 versus C4 plants. Mesophyll cells, C3 leaf, major site of photosynthesis, C4 leaf, crans anatomy, site of initial CO2 fixation only. Bundle shed cells, C3 leaf, non-photosynthetic or modest chloroplast, C4 leaf, large chloroplast rich, site of Kelvin cycle. Intercellular space, C3 leaf, abundant between mesophyll cells, C4 leaf, reduced to facilitate CO2 shuttling. So friends, we have completed all these question answers. From chapter 11, Photosynthesis in Higher Plants, we have already studied the short notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like, hype the video and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.